Hey people, it's Tuesday, December the 22nd. It is 9:06 in the evening. And I'm here on Dundas Street East. And I'm walking towards Sherbourne Street. And I'll be doing a little nighttime walk around downtown East. Let's see what kind of things are happening around here at night, as opposed to the daytime when I shoot most of my videos. You know, Dundas and Sherbourne, which I just walked through, is probably the intersection with the worst reputation in this part of downtown East. Queen and Sherbourne is another one, a little further south. When I walked through there was quite a few interesting people, you could say, milling about, but I just sort of kept my camera low and no one really noticed. So now we're continuing east on Dundas. See the top of the Aura condominium. Just crossing George Street. Looks pretty empty down there right now. Here's the famous Fillmore Strip Club. It's funny they don't have all the neon turned on, just some of it. I did a walk along George Street a little while ago. It was a daytime walk. Kind of quiet out right now. I mean, obviously the city's in lockdown. It's a Tuesday night. I've done like a number of walks through this neighborhood in the daytime. You know, and I've always commented that, you know, it's not as bad as people make it out to be and all that. I mean, actually, I live in this area and I've never had any real problems personally. But there's always the odd commenter who says something like, yeah, try going through there at night. So I thought, well, I walk around through here at night all the time. Might as well just bring my camera out and record my night walk. I mean, no question, when I was walking through Dundas and Sherbourne, yeah, there was a little bit of uneasiness just because you never know what some of those people are going to do if they notice you have a camera. People have taken offense before to my camera on quite a few occasions, so this is something you have to be mindful about. Walk down one of these side streets. This is Mutual Street. I will admit, I mean, if you come through here on a warm summer evening when there's no pandemic, yeah, there's definitely a lot of activity and sketchy people about, and you know, you might see some unpleasant things here and there, or have people shout at you and stuff like that. Of course, people ask you for money all the time. But in my experience, no one has ever, like, actually confronted me in any serious way. Just keep walking, and that's it, you know? Like, they rarely come after you in any way, you know? They just say what they have to say. You know, maybe you nod, maybe you don't, and just keep walking, and that's it. Crossing Shooter Street. This neighborhood is transforming pretty rapidly right now. This is a new condo tower going up. Just over here, there's a huge new development. And this building right on the corner is new. This was the site of one of downtown's biggest parking lots. It spanned the entire block from Queen all the way to Shooter. And then they built this condo at the northern end. And now they're filling up the rest of the lot with more buildings. I think that's great. Although we will lose this awesome view of the financial district skyline here. That was the one good thing about this parking lot. It provided an unobstructed view. So it's about 0 degrees Celsius right now. Very little wind. It's actually a pretty nice night for a walk. This is Dalhousie Street. Yeah, it's awfully quiet out here tonight. It actually seems more sketchy when no one's around than it does when there's all kinds of interesting people milling about. Another new condo tower. Oh, and I think I hear the singing man. There he is. He's the guy that you see all the time in this neighborhood and along Yonge Street. He rarely ever goes west of Yonge Street. Tends to stick to the east side. He likes to walk right in the street, often between cars, holding up an invisible microphone and singing rather incoherently. There was one song I sort of recognized that he would sing all the time. Can't remember the name of it, but it was definitely a song that I recognized, but he doesn't seem to sing that one anymore. Now I don't know what he's singing. So this leads up into Ryerson University, so I won't go that way. Because that's not particularly sketchy, as people like to say. So we're back on Dundas. So what I'll do is I'll walk up to Jarvis. Then we'll walk up Jarvis for a block or two. Now we're heading north on Jarvis. It is Deadsville out here, man. And we're going to get a nighttime shot of Hooker Harvey's. I don't think I've had that in any of my videos yet. I've gone by it in the daytime a number of times, but this will be the first nighttime Hooker Harvey's. And it looks like it's open. That's good to know. And there's not one single hooker standing there in the corner. That's what it was known for once upon a time. The corner used to be a gathering spot for so-called ladies of the night and some men of the evening. And some men posing as ladies of the night. So now we're on Gerard Street, heading east. And we're coming up on George Street again, so why not? I'll just take a little stroll down George Street. Thank you.
tonight.
Oh! Yeah, no, you reminded me.
The first time.
Mm-hmm. This is the Seton House Men's Shelter. It's the largest men's shelter in the city. I recently did this George Street walk in the daytime, just a few weeks ago. It was probably my most viewed video I've had in quite a few months, I would say. Just because the street definitely has a notorious reputation, at least this block. It's really only contained to this one block that the bad reputation applies. I don't know if you saw that guy, but I see him around the neighborhood all the time, constantly, for years. I always feel bad for him. So now we're back at Dundas Street once again. Down Sherbourne to Queen. you know, trying to hit all three of the so-called hotspots in downtown East. George Street, Dundas and Sherbourne, and Queen and Sherbourne. Well, it looks like one out of four working. It's better than I expected. Sam's Food Store. I've mentioned it in some other videos, but I went in there after midnight on a Friday in the summer one time, and it was the most eye-opening convenience store visit I've ever had. But it's one of the only places in the downtown area that I know of where you can get Faygo soda pop. My friend sort of introduced me to Faygo. So now we're walking south on Sherbourne. We have Moss Park, just kitty corner. And there are the Moss Park apartments. Here's the most colorful Dollarama store in the downtown area. Just had to step over a pool of vomit. So that was Queen and Sherborne. Pretty quiet at the moment. And I think I will wrap up this little walk around downtown East. Just up ahead at this local landmark. Which appears to be closed right now. But there you go. The famous Kim's Convenience. Just like on TV. So I hope you enjoyed my nighttime walk around downtown East through the three worst parts of the city, apparently. The downtown part, anyway. And I survived. I survived completely unscathed. So if you did enjoy this, by all means, please subscribe. Like, share, comment, tell your friends and your family and your sworn enemies. Hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. And be sure to always check back, because I will continue.